Hello, boys and girls. This is Dr. Lee. Welcome to the series of Math Olympiad for Primary School. Today, we're tasked with determining the two exact moments after 5 p.m. when the minute and hour hands of a clock form a 90-degree angle. Before we dive into the solution, I encourage you to hit the pause button, grab a pen and paper, and give it your best shot. When you're ready, feel free to share your answer in the comments. Then we'll explore the solution together. Let's get started. Let's begin with the basics. An hour consists of 60 minutes. And on an analog clock, each minute is represented by a small gap or unit. At 5 p.m., the hour hand points at the number 5, which we'll consider as the 25th unit, while the minute hand is at the 0 unit. We also know that in 1 hour, the minute hand moves 60 units and the hour hands move 5 units. This gives us a speed ratio of 12 to 1. This means T minutes after 5 p.m., the hour hands is at position 25 plus t over 12, and the minute hand is at position t. To form a 90 degree angle between these two hands, their positional difference must be 15 units. For case 1, where the hour hand is ahead of minute hands, we have the equation 25 plus t over 12 minus t equals 15, which can be simplified to t equals 10 and 10 over 11 minutes. This is when they form the first 90 degree angle after 5 p.m. For case 2, with the minute hands ahead of the hour hand, we have the equation t minus 25 plus t over 12 equals 15, which can simplify as t equals 43 and 7 over 11 minutes. This is when they form the second 90 degree angle after 5 p.m. Now, let's consider an alternative method, which might be more efficient in a competition setting. If we assume the hour hand does not move from its position after 5 p.m., the minute hand would need to move 10 minutes to form the first 90 degree angle. Although this assumption isn't accurate, it simplifies our calculation to 10 times 1 plus 1 over 11, giving the same result of 10 and 10 over 11 minutes. This approach is succinct and effective. Similarly, for the second 90 degree angle, if we assume the hour hand remains stationary, the minute hand would need to move 40 minutes. This leads us to the actual timing of 40 times 1 plus 1 over 11, resulting in 43 and 7 over 11 minutes. That concludes today's lesson. I hope you found this methodology insightful and applicable to similar problems. Stay tuned for more intriguing questions in this series. Until next time, take care and bye-bye.